in the bio nano info level, you can go to that level of identifying which you want to retain, which you want to propagate, because you can go to that level. For example, if you can suck your flower, can you get that honey? Because only the honeybee is having such a minute sting by which it can select the pollen, extract the exact honey that is present. That part of sophisticated system is available only with the bee. So if you go in the bio nano level, what to retain, even if there is a connectivity of intimate bonds, having at least, for example, 0.000, we can put 10 or 12 zeros to the level of a micro spatial gap between these two bands. You can select one thing and you can just neglect the other thing, which you cannot do in tangible devices. So in the nano level, retainers and propagators are well identified. Now we are having lot of nanoparticles for gene delivery. We are having nanosensors which are compatible with the molecular compounds or molecular structures like DNA biomolecules. We are having nanosensors for biomolecules, nanoparticles for gene delivery, and lot of newly bio nano machines are developed for space applications. Everything is going on in the society. Recently, lot of people are doing researches. NASA Research Institute, they have funded for terrestrial or terrain manipulation and climate prediction, etc. They have instituted two projects. One is the all-terrain astronaut bio nano gear system. They have developed an all-terrain astronaut bio nano gear system. And the Terra Explorer system, they have developed a Terra Explorer system. It is funded by NASA Institute. And National Science Foundation, they have developed a project. Now they are developing a project for protein-based nanosensors and nanomotors. Now the project is with the 15 billions, they are doing the project. They have to, complete it by 2011 or 12. So this is a project available like that. And number two, I want to say, there is also one NAGBO project in which new or novel or improved nanoparticles, chemistries, and apparatus for nanobiotechnology. The project is known as, I told the expansion, abbreviation is NAGPO. Novel and improved nanoparticles, chemistry, and apparatus for nanobiotechnology is known as NAGPO. It is also in the process. The third thing, Dr. Chi Ming Ho of the California University, he is a great scientist in microelectromagnetic field physics. He has developed a lot of new models. His recent development is micro and nano fluidics. Micro and nano fluidics. How convert everything into fluid or flow model so that to have a target delivery of either a drug or a diagnostic tool. So now he is also doing a similar research. Like what innumerable researchers are going on in various parts of this society. Now coming into the nano, bio and information technology, I want to put it in a very clear-cut method. Number one, the body is full of lot of micro factories. The body is full of, what is body? Body is a cluster of innumerable congregations, knots and module conjunctions of sophisticated, complex, intricate, inexplicable, mysterious micro factories. This is a definition for body, biological definition for body. Lot of such micro factories are there in the body. Each and every cell is having intricate multi-connectivity networks with a lot of signal processing. Each and everything is like that. Can we identify them? We cannot identify. First of all, what I've told is about bio. Body is a set of cells, and each and every cell is having lot of signal networks and various other channels. This is bio. But by using nano cytokines, you can induce the microsystems of the body to create a desired phenotype by which we can understand these things. Number two, this is nano. Third thing, by means of a simulation, you can organize as well as adjust the functionalities inside. This is info by which we can understand the destinal modularities. What is it? Destinal or control modularities of the human body, which are all the determinant factors of human life and functioning. This is the convergence. So, to start with, understanding about the body and complex network is bio, and having a deeper study by means of imparting a nano cytokine particle by means of which the desirable phenotype is induced by the microprocessing units inside the body is a nano, and observing the same thing by a simulation by which we can adjust, monitor, associate and organize the functionalities inside is info, by which we are arriving at the novel, unidentified, mysterious, as well as the basic structural novelties and nodalities of the human body and human life can be understood. That is a convergence. So for understanding this human life as a whole, it is proved that bio nano info, it is very essential, unavoidable. I have already told, even convergence people told, cognotechnologists will think, biotechnologists will analyze, nanotechnologists will execute, and info technologists will monitor. So to think we need somebody, to analyze you need somebody, to execute you need somebody, to monitor you need somebody, like Chaturbhuja of Vishnu, in which he is having Shankar Chakra, Gada and Padma. We must have a Chaturbhuja Siddhanta in technology also, in which these four things are united to create something. So this is very much essential. So nanoparticles of silver, aluminium oxide, single walled and multi walled carbon nanotubes, along with gold particles also, titanium dioxide, innumerable things they are used now. And recently there is Dr. Jacob Oswald, he is the research and development wing director of the US Army, and he has proposed application of this bio nano info technologies into various areas, like number one, war, to get information, to transform information, for information security, for making bio nano sensors or astronauts or space vehicles or space drivers or space monitors, and also for our own various other methods of propaganda and reconnaissance, etc. In war it is to be utilized. And number two, on environment. In environment also, for degradation measurement, for considering about the bio remediation, for landscaping and land planning, for water resources management and water utility, everything for distribution, it is very much required in environment. In installation services like transformation and power units, it is very much essential. In information technology also, for high performance computational areas like geospatial engineering, it is very much essential. So this bio nano info technology has become all pervading and all essential, and it has such a very complex system which can enroll into the process of governing the all-round benefit of various emerging systems of the world. That is the greatness of this technology. Apart from which, I want to say something very simple. If a person should understand something about nanotechnology, the person should have got a taste at all. Basically, that should be a taste. Without a person, most of the people like J.C. Bose, Alfred Einstein and Albert Einstein, then various other people, the great scientists, they have got some sort of thirst as well as taste. Thirst as well as taste towards nature. For example, J.C. Bose, you know how much he loved plants. Apart from studying, how many botany students are loving plants? They are touching plants because of compulsion of experiments or some projects. Otherwise, nobody is interested in seeing plants. So we must love, if you are studying biotechnology, naturally you should have an inclination towards life. You must love life. You must be surprising at the wonders of the life. You must be shocked by the mysteries of the life. You must be kindled by the orderly presentation of the life and its expansions. You must be thirst about knowing life more and more. Unless you have these genes, who is going to implant this gene at this age? I don't know. So unless you have some sort of craving, thirst, some trial pursuit or instinct inside you, you cannot love something. Unless you have this thing, you cannot understand biotechnology. See, thrusting biotechnology inside for exams is different from understanding biotechnology and becoming a shining student. You can, nobody say, that's what I told. There are lot of urges. Like competition is an urge, coercion is an urge, inspiration is an urge, emergency is an urge. So by these urges you can be driven to write some examinations or study something. Like nanotechnology, whenever you see that there is something subtler than the subtlest particle, immediately you must be having some love, some thirst, some sort of mystery, some sort of craving, some sort of some driver you should possess for understanding these particles, either info, cogno or anything else. So the driver, you should sit calm and develop to see the driver which is already there inside. Nanoparticle means you all know that it is 10 to the power of minus 9, 1 billionth of a thing, you know that. It is a so minutest particle, somebody said in an example, it is the amount of hair that grows.